I bet you love challenges, and I have one heck of a challenge for you. So the challenge is smile for 48 hours. Sounds simple? Well, try it. It's probably not that easy, especially if you're around some serious and very busy people who try to break your mood and intention to smile. And especially if you're doing some exercise, some really hardcore exercise, try it. If you have done it before, you know, that's a pretty awesome challenge. Let's call it a challenge or opportunity to improve and grow. But let's start with the basics. Why would you want to do it in the first place? Well, I bet as a leader, you definitely want to get more influence. And as you probably know from sales, communications, that smile is one of the best ways how to sell or influence people. Why? Because people are mostly influenced by your energy and the flavor of energy, by your emotions. And smile kicks it right up to that high note, and people love that. And therefore, they're more likely to want to do whatever you want them to do. And it's easier to transfer your message because it's a bit more loose and a bit more relaxed. I guess you're already having some objections. So maybe you say, I don't have time for this kind of things. Already my busy mind, I'm working all day long and squeezing in one more thing is just not in my schedule. Well, probably you would say that because you don't really realize how much influence, especially in long term, the smile can give you. Think about it. Obviously, you could force people in a short term, but in the long term, those relationships are probably not going to work out for the best. However, if you make people want to do what you want them to do, it's a win-win, and you have a way more stable relationships. So as we touched, the smile will work on your influence through raising your energy and making more intense emotions flowing through you. So let's get to the core of it. How do you raise your energy in general as well, not only with smile? So how you could even boost your effects from the experiment by smiling to even benefit even more. So first of all, we know that we have body maintenance with diet, exercise, rest. We also have our mind with focus, having clear set vision on outcome, goals, steps, so we can direct our teammates to wherever we want them to go, so they know exactly what they need to do. So we have this laser sharp focus, and if we have more narrow focus, there's more chance of actually getting what they want. And the third one is heart, and this is the most neglected one for most of us, unfortunately. And that's where I want to focus on our heart and emotions. And that's why I choose the smile, because I believe that if we work on the basics regularly, they work every single time and we're guaranteed to succeed. And if we work on our basics diligently, we're going to become pros. And it's simple. Like sometimes when we talk about positive mindset, positivity, yay. When you're depressed, how easy is it for you to understand what exactly does positivity mean and how to get there? Well, most of us understand that, especially if you're under depression. Well, not even touching that subject at this moment, but you get the point. It's not easy to understand what does it actually mean to be positive. However, everyone understands smile. Everyone has experienced it. Everyone knows how to do it. You just contract your facial muscles and you do it. And the trick is, and the best part out of it is, that if you smile, even if it's a fake smile like this one, it works. It still works because your body sends signal to your brain biochemically and tells the rest of the body through the endorphins and other hormones that you're having fun, there's something fun, and we can relax a bit, chill, and release a bit of the stress. So that's why smile is so powerful, so simple, everyone understands it, and that's why I recommend this challenge for you. We start with the basics, it's simple, and everyone actually can do it, and it's 100% guaranteed to work if you persist in it. So once we have the basics, we know what to do. We have to smile. The second step is to name your smile. So why would you want to name it? So it's just the next level, next step. If you name your smile with some kind of positive emotion, then you put a specific, exact flavor to it. For example, it could be playfulness, curiosity, happiness, cheerfulness, joy, passion, or any other emotion you like. And I would love to suggest to choose between 3 to 12 emotions. Why not only one? Well, if your mood is down, it might be hard for us to go for that really high aimed emotions like excitement, passion. And if you feel like neutral or slightly even below that, it could be hard to immediately go there. And if you have some step-by-step progression towards it, it makes our life that much easier. If you start with the happiness, it might be easier. And second is, we don't want too many options. It will just be overwhelming and we cannot remember them. So limit it, let's say between 3 to 12. Any number will be fine, as long as you have a clear list of set of options you can choose from. So once we have our smile, once we have named it, so we can identify it and call it out whenever, like curious smile, like playful smile, it's easier to get in that state. And the third one is awareness. That's why I always finish my videos, my posts, smile and be present. Be present what's happening around you. If you're smiling, what's happening with your body, your posture, your emotion, your mindset, what kind of thoughts you have. All this contributes to your emotional well-being and your energy levels. So let's go a bit slower through this. So once we have our smile, we have named it, and we're trying to be present, where we can be present of. So let's start with our trinity, body, mind, heart. So first, body. Try to get a really nice, confident posture. Chest out, shoulders slightly back, straight spine, standing upright. Looking maybe straight, probably not looking down. Having a really clear, confident voice, talking with confidence, of course, if you can, as much as you can, of course. And that's the body leveraging. Second one is mind. Try to be aware what kind of thoughts you have. Are these thoughts empowering, leading towards your goal, or maybe trying to slow you down, doubt yourself, and maybe even change your posture? So try to be aware what happens in your mind. And third one is emotions. Just be aware and try to name your emotions. Doesn't mean that you have to neglect them, ignore them. It just means you try to observe what's in there, try to understand what's happening there, and eventually you will get better and better at choosing and understanding your emotions, and then suddenly starting to laugh. Once you observe some bad emotion, you start to think, start to ask empowering questions. That's another really awesome tip and trick how to get yourself into higher energy. Just ask more quality questions. So I think this is a good point to finish this video. You have your challenge, smile and observe. Smile and be present. How often you smile during these next 48 hours. And try to really pay attention to those specifically busy moments, like having a morning routine, workouts, doing yoga exercises, talking to people, sitting in the meetings, browsing through the feed, all these mindless activities, or some of them could be mindless, some of them could be already automatic, waiting for your turn in line, any of those small places where you normally would just tune out, just try to observe what's happening with your face. You probably noticed during this video, I already lost my smile many, many, many times. That's not the point. Point is to build that muscle. Build that muscle, observe, and maybe even integrate it as a habit in your daily life, in your productive routines. Hopefully this video helped, hopefully inspired you to understand how important and how fun it is to have this smile, practice and challenge, smile, be present. As always, like and share this video if you liked it or gained any value out of it. Subscribe for more videos like these, of course. And smile. Be present. See you on the next one.